please welcome solver Priya Lakhani, founder and CEO, Century Tech.
Hello, everybody. Hi. Thank you. So 7 years ago, through my previous venture, I was funding schools in India for the underprivileged. And I was also very, very fortunate that I was put on a government advisory board in England. But when I was on that advisory board, I came across some really, really mortifying statistics that the rest of the world was clearly aware of. And those statistics were that there are tens of millions of children out there with no access to education at all. There are 190 million children that lack the basic literacy skills to give them opportunity and choice in life. And we know that there are severe problems with our education system. But what I could also see was that one-size-fits-all delivery of education for those of the children who are in school was also inadequate. You know what it's like. You've been to school. Your children go to school. That constant teacher stand in the front, preach to 30 children in the same way. Every classroom has a bell curve of abilities. There are always children that are left struggling behind and those that are under-challenged. So I was thinking, well, teachers, what are you doing? And it was mortifying to find out that 3/4 of teachers in the United Kingdom consider quitting their jobs in the next 3 years. Why? Because they are overworked. Because they're spending 60% of their time micro-marking, micro-assessing, collecting data from mark books, then turning into data analysts, trying to figure out which child doesn't understand what. Then they have to make that intervention. And it takes an awful lot of time. So we know that the education system, as it is today, this factory model of education, is completely broken. But when I was going into these schools because I was curious, I could also see that I had more technology on my phone than in the classroom. The classroom, they had moved from a blackboard to a whiteboard. And then I looked at that learning management system, the LMS, that we've invested millions and millions of pounds in the last 2 decades. The learning management system is where innovation went to die. It simply digitizes exactly what you're currently doing. You give homework, assignments, they do the homework, they give it back to you, you mark it. They just do it online and it saves photocopying costs. So what is going on? What about that technology on my phone that is so smart, that helps me shop, it helps me save, it helps me get to great hotels all around the world? What about that? So after a couple of nano degrees in artificial intelligence and in neuroscience, I thought, what about a system that learns how the brain learns? What about if we think about what education is all about? It feels like something that's inflicted on us, but it shouldn't be. It should be joyous. It should be accessible to all. It should be top tier. It should be differentiated. It should be personalized. So at Century, we were very fortunate last year at New York, at MIT, to present a system that learns how the brain learns. It's been 5 to 6 years of a labor of love, all based in London, in the United Kingdom. But it tracks every single movement and every interaction of every child. It can host any content, any curriculum. It learns your knowledge, your skills, your gaps in knowledge, your gaps in skills, your pace of learning, your difficulty levels, your memory function, your preferences, your emotions. And it will dynamically differentiate for any individual child. It removes that one-size-fits-all delivery of education that I was speaking about, and it differentiates and allows teachers to then take that information, deep data insights that they receive, and make timely, targeted interventions. Through help from other universities, we have established over 2 years with 11,000 students at the beginning of Century, it increases outcomes across the board by 30%. And what I was most proud of as a social impact entrepreneur, solely focused on how can we make the world better, is that those students that are economically disadvantaged progressed just as well as their peers. So we have the Harrow School for Boys, we have the Jess in Dubai, but we also have Syrian refugees in Lebanon. And we are now the first artificially intelligent platform that has been rolled out across nation systems this year. So they are starting to do something. How many future of education talks do you all go to? The future of education. Should there be AI in education? It is not about the future of education, and you need to stop talking about that. When you talk about the future of education, you give yourself some sort of false sense of security that this is something that we need to do later. There is urgency now. So all of you, I ask you, go to school, go speak to your head teachers, ask them, what are you doing today, and do something about it. Thank you very much.